Hi, welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today I'm going to talk to you about a pen by Inoxchrome. Inoxchrome is a brand made from Spain that was created in 1946, and it has been in production until I'm not sure today or very recently, but as far as I know, they were struggling and there were even rumors they would go out of business, but apparently not yet. But as I said, it is quite an old brand, 1946, from Spain, and this is a pen that I found in a store that has second-hand items. And I already made a video where I opened the bag with some pens that I bought that day. And this is the Inoxchrome 77. And what I know about this pen is that the model was produced since 1966 to 1980, but sorry, from 1966 to 1990, but this specific model or variation that I has been produced between 1970 to 1980. So we have a 10 years range. The pen is in its original box, which is a box made of plastic with a plastic transparent lid. Here it says Inoxchrome. Also on this paper lining, you can see embossed Inoxchrome over and over. And here there is room for two ink cartridges. These two slots were empty. I just put two ink cartridges here, and as you can see, they take the modern international size cartridge. These are Caveco cartridges. And the pen. Here it is. It is a pen that I find quite interesting in its design. Let me take the case out and let me show you the pen. So, this pen, as you can see, it has a shape that, in my opinion, reminds me a lot the Parker 45. I have one here, and if you look at it is very, very similar. The size, the width is very similar. The steel cap, but you can have different variations for the 45, but the steel cap, black barrel, only the shape of the barrel, the shape of the cap, only the shape of the nib is clearly different. And I find this very interesting because I like this design of the Parker 45. I think it's like almost the perfect design. So this is really similar to that one. The pen, it has this convex top of the cap. It has a convex bottom of the barrel, a very simple barrel that tapers down, the cap tapers down also at the top. The clip has this little thing to grab your clothes, and it is quite stiff, but it slips very well into your pocket. To see the details, let me try to show you the engravings. On the cap, it says there, made in Spain, Inoxchrome 77, and then Inoxchrome again. So that's what is engraved on the cap. The cap, as the Parker 45, is a slip fit cap. It has a metal ring here, and it has a very interesting nib. When you read about this pen online, a lot of people say that this pen reminds the Schiffer nib. And I have one here, also black with a steel cap, also with a steel nib, and if you see, the shape reminds us the shape of the clip, of the nib, of the chiffer. Yes, it does. But in my opinion, this pen, the shape of the nib, reminds me more of these vintage Parker, pilot costume. In this particular pen, the shape of the breather hole is oval instead of circular, but it really reminds me more of this pen than the chiffer. But maybe it is like a mix between the chiffer and this pilot. So it is a quite interesting nib design, at least in my opinion. Let me take this out of the way, and let's focus again. Try to focus closer, sorry. And what we have here on the nib. It is interesting because the nib is engraved, I would say, upside down from what we are used to. And to read what the nib says, you have to put the pen like this. And you can see in Ox Chrome, right behind the breather hole, and up 77. Very hard to show you because of the lights, but it says there 77 and beneath Inox Chrome. Also, another interesting characteristic is the two slits. Here is one, another there, the two additional slits on the nib. I don't know if they were meant to give an extra softness to the nib. I don't find this nib to be extremely soft, although it has some give to it, and you can have some line variation, but they are here. I couldn't find information about that. The section is very long, made of plastic, as the Parker 45, I would say. As I told you, it takes international cartridges, short cartridges, but the pen came originally, but I washed it and replaced it with cartridges. It came with these original, let me try to show you, with this original converter, which is an aerometric type converter, and it has the instructions there to fill. And what it says there is, I'm not sure I can read it through the camera. I need to see it out of the camera. It says, para llenar, presione-se varias veces, and then Inox Chrome, made in Spain, use tinta de calidad. So it says to fill, press several times, and then it says use quality ink. So that's what's written there. Sorry for my Spanish accent. About the pen, another characteristic. It posts very well, very deeply, like the Parker 45. Sorry for the comparison, but I can't skip that. And it really posts very securely, very deeply, and it makes the pen more, it's one of those cases where the pen is more comfortable to use posted than unposted, at least in my opinion. Even though, if it is unposted, it has the full length size, but with the cap posted, I think it makes much more sense, and even in an aesthetic thing, it is more beautiful. And then, Let's just see how the pen compares in size with other pens. And you have here the Lamy Safari and the Parker Dufold. And it is a little millimeters shorter than these two big pens, but it is a full-sized pen. So I don't think it is a bad choice. It's really a nice size for a fountain pen, in my opinion. And bottoms aligned, this is the difference where when unkept and unposted. So very nice size, and I think it has a very interesting and well made design. And now I will cap all the three pens, and I will go for the notepad and make the writing sample. So here we have our paper, and now let's make the writing sample. First of all, let's see if the pen writes, because it was unkept when I was showing the pen to you. And this is, yes, it writes, the Inox Chrome 77. And the nib, I would say it is a medium nib. There is no letter indicating the nib size. And the ink is Caveco Midnight Blue. Sorry, this is all out of alignment. And the paper is the usual Rhodia dot pad. So first, let's see. This pen really puts on paper a quite nice amount of ink, as you can see. It is a quite wet, and it makes the drying time a little slow. It writes really, really well. It's very, very smooth, in my opinion. And if you write it on reverse, it has a finer line. About line variation, this is the natural line variation you'll get, which, as you can see, it is some. And if you press it a little harder, maybe because of those slits on the nib, I don't know, you can have some extra line variation. So in this sense, I'm very happy with this pen. It writes really, really well, and it is a very well-made pen. I really like it, and I would say it replaces the Parker 45, or is a very good match to that pen. It's not inferior anyhow. But this particular pen, and I didn't find anything about it in online, this particular pen starts to go dry and then skip. I don't understand really what happened. I've cleaned this pen, I have soaked it. It had lots of dried ink. I put it in the ultrasonic cleaner lots of times. I just can't take out the feed. The feed is just a little bit misaligned, but not much. And the pen really writes perfectly with a good amount of flow. The problem is when I write for a while, the pen runs dry, and the only way to make the pen work again is not pressing the nib hard. I don't have to do anything, just take the cartridge out and, oops, put it back on place like this, just this, and the pen starts writing immediately. So I don't really know what is the problem. I would say it's some problem of air exchange, air versus ink flow, that makes the pen go dry because maybe the air doesn't get in the cartridge. I don't know how to fix this. If you have any idea, and be aware that I don't know how to take this feed apart, please tell me if you have an idea what may be causing this. I would say it is a airflow issue inside the pen. If it was not that problem, this would be a great pen to write with, and with a very nice flow that would allow you to make quick notes, because the pen is up to it. The nib has some feedback, but it is smooth, and you can definitely have some line variation, even more if you use the pen upside down. So this is a very interesting versatile pen, and I'm just sad it has that ink flow problem. Maybe it is fixable, I just need to find out how. I hope you like this pen. This is an unusual pen to find reviews or information about it. If you have any other information about it, please let me know. And if you like the video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe our YouTube channel. And thank you, and please come back soon for more videos like this. See you next time. Bye.